a private residence, man.
What's up, dudes? This is the Lockpicking Lebowski. And I'm your host, the dude. I appreciate you joining me for this very special presentation of Down the Rabbit Hole, a padlock journey. If at any time this broadcast experiences catastrophe or an outage, just try to tune back in. This is really experimentation, so just tune back in, because if something goes terribly wrong, I'm going to get back up on that horse and we're going to keep galloping. Let's get started. Hope you stick with me. We're going to go down the rabbit hole and it's going to get weird. It's going to get dark. But I hope you find it interesting. So let's start with prizes. You will need to prepare yourselves for doing screenshots, because the questions will be in Braille, they will be in Morse code, they will be in Spanish, they will be in English. So, one prize will be the Guardian's key card cable lock. I think it's pretty cool. Another prize is going to be Sparrow sticker, some Kwikset and Schlage key blanks, a 12-piece Huck broken key extractor kit, a 2-piece dimple pick set. We've got some 600 grit and 1000 grit sandpaper. And also, we've got 4 different challenge locks pinned by the dude, and they will be going to somebody very, very lucky soul who answers our question correctly. We've got Spring Fling, Precision Tuned, Cheap Date, and a nice shiny mirror surface Schlage Silver Surfer, all pinned by the dude. So, we will from time to time get to those quiz questions. Another prize, though, will be this Medico 51S 6-pin biaxial mortise cylinder. So let me get another prize. Hope I didn't forget any prizes, but that's basically what we're looking at. So let's get started. We're going to be referring to all these different locks with a number. That way when you're commenting, basically you'll have a number to refer to. The first one is, and we're going to go from the latest to the earliest, so we're going to go back in time. Master Lock. This is the Master Lock Pro Series 7050. It actually has a chain, I have the chain off of it at the moment, but Master Lock was founded in 1921, and basically, they were used in commercial. This can be used in commercial and industrial applications. It's got dual ball bearings. It's got a steel body. It's chrome plated, a boron alloy shackle, and the edge key control is available. It's got a rekeyable cylinder, and it's fitted with 5 spool pins as drivers, but it's a 6-pin chambered lock. So, of course, I took the initiative to, thanks to Big Willie, I pinned it up with a 6-pin and changed the longer key pins to serrated and added a serrated, which is a number, chamber number 6, added a serrated driver. So it's like 5 spools and 1 serrated. That Tharby Master Pro Series 7050. Onward down the rabbit hole. Lock number 54. This is a Sergeant Queso deadbolt. I don't have a patent date on this, but the key is very interesting. It's a dimple lock, and it's a 6-sided key. If you look at that, you've got dimples on the side, but you've got 2 different planes on the length of the key there. There are actually 3 rows of pins. There are not 6 rows of pins, so this key is reversible. I have tried to pick this lock, but I haven't had any success, since it's definitely going to take a lot more practice to do something like that. Onward down the rabbit hole. Where's lock number 53? Here we go. Lock number 53. This is a Remington trigger lock. I believe this is a wafer lock. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, I believe 5 wafers. This is not plastic, it's actually metal. It has been discontinued, but obviously non-key retaining, and it just ratchets shut to try to prevent disaster with a weapon. I wish I had more information on that, but I do not. Let's see. Next up is a very, very interesting lock. Lock number 52. This is a Psychos, I'll call it, card lock. And it came with 2 card keys, 1 small, sort of a pocket size, and then another one, and I believe you, yeah, if the master card is lost, you can buy a replacement from the retailer with the spare card number. Anyhow, what you do is, and these are reversible, so it only uses 3 of these holes, but you basically insert this into this little slot here and push to the left, and that's what opens the lock. That is very similar to the prize that I'm offering the Guardians cable lock. Psychos. I would guess that this is from the 90s. I know they did and still do motorcycle locks like U-locks. And I think that dates from around 1992, so. The next lock we have is lock number 51. And this is the conch magnet keys. This comes with 2 keys. And basically, you just lay it on the side, and that's what opens the lock. This is actually probably from Taiwan. I think it's a 28mm. It also comes in a larger version, 37mm, and also comes with a lot longer shackle, like for a bike lock. You can find these all over eBay, and they come in lots of different names. They've been licensed under the name Magna Guard, Mercury Mark II, Camel, Globalman, Genti, Punch Lock, Luster Line. IFAM even took a stab at it. And there's also a, I guess, a Russian version, Nixtukas, which you'll find currently, one is currently listed on eBay. So you can find them fairly cheap, you know, 10 or 15 bucks, something like that. You can buy them in bulk. I know there's a listing currently for three for 30 bucks, I think. So pretty cool. That is lock number 51, the Conch Magnetic Lock. Next up, I think Potty 314 will be interested in this one. This is lock number 50. This is the Gorin. G-O-R-I-N. The Gorin Digital. Let's see if we can focus on that. It's the Gorin Digital 35. Let's see if I have any information on Gorin. Gorin Digital. They also have been under the name Iowa, which also makes Walkmans. But Gorin, I think, makes bike locks. You can translate their current product page for lots of different locks. But basically, this is a four-digit combination lock. And you basically press the four digits and then slide this at the bottom. And that's the switch that opens your lock. This can be decoded. I've seen a YouTube video where people decode this, but I'm going to... Hopefully I haven't given away the combination. That's not what we're going to do here. We're not going to be giving away combinations for this broadcast, webcast. So that was lock number 50, the Gorin Digital. This is lock number 49, the CCL. I believe this is a wafer lock. Now, some people mistake the logo. I saw a YouTube video where somebody thought it was TDD. And I fully understand that. It could probably be confusing. But it's actually CCL. You know your history. That's Corbin Cabinet Lock. I'm not really sure what these lock up. But this is actually called the Husky. And of course, CCL is still in business. So that's lock number 49. And lock number 48, we're just going to go ahead and get to right quick. This is another of the same one. This one just looks a bit weathered. And it is a Cat 30, just like the other one. So actually, even though these are from different sources, this key will open the other lock, and vice versa. So I'm not really sure what's up with that or what they lock up. I don't know if this is like for like a gas meter type deal or what, but this is definitely weathered, and it looks like somebody actually tried to file off the top of that or something. It's pretty well scratched up. It's lock number 48, another CCL. On down the rabbit hole. Lock number 47. This is a laminated combination padlock. The only thing on it is the words Hong Kong. That's all that's on it, besides hardened on the shackle. Basically, you enter in your combination, in this case, 000, and you press in on the shackle and release it, and it opens. And I thought, man, you know, there's really no visible way to change this. And I thought, you wouldn't just buy a lock and it's 000 and be stuck with that combination. And I thought, well, you know, knowing what I know about locks like these, there's usually a button on the side. Now, this arrow only shows that it's pointing to the middle row there, so you don't get confused when you're dialing in your combination. But I took a look, And then down inside the shackle hole, way down inside there, on the right-hand side, can't see it like this, but way down inside there is a button. And you basically stick something like a nail or something down inside there and just kind of twist to the right, and you hold in on that button and you change your combination. And then you release it, and that's your new combination. And it does work. I've tried it. So that's lock number 47. Laminated combination padlock, Hong Kong. Next up is lock number 46. And this is a weird looking master lock, shrouded, laminated master lock, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. This says 37, so I'll just call it master lock number 37. But when you open it, all these pieces are loose. They're not connected. It's just the strangest thing. And as far as I know, I guess they still make these. Master lock number 37. Pretty beefy. On down the rabbit hole we go. And I've tried to put these in order best I could, but if they're not in perfect order as far as chronological order, you know, you have to help me out on that. But this is a really big, beefy master lock. This is master lock number 6. Laminated. Got the number A227, and it's also on the key here. Looks to be a pin tumbler lock. Looks like it's a four pinner. Still works smooth. Not really sure what year this is from, but I can't say I've ever seen a number 6, so this is our keyway here. Lock number 45, master lock, laminated padlock, master lock number 6. On down the rabbit hole we go. This is lock number 44. Another master lock. Master lock number... Well, it says 263 on it. Warded. I have no idea what you would lock up with this, why it's shaped like that. Never seen a lock like that before. Never seen a master lock like that or with an old logo like that. No idea what year that's from, but maybe being that it's warded gives us some sort of a clue. I don't know. It's master lock. I'll call it number 263 just because that's all that I found on it. So that's our lock number 44, the master lock, warded, laminated. Next up on the list, lock number 43. This one's from Big Willie the Locksmith. And I was happy to throw this in here. This is a Willie Bow, Wilson Bohannon. It's got Our Lady of Mount Carmel monogrammed on the side here. Wilson Bohannon. Who knows where this came from, because there's a lot of Our Lady of Mount Carmel schools nationwide. Wilson Bohannon is still in business. They still do custom monogramming. They still offer 4, 5, and 6 pin cores. And I guess they're not really paying a lot as far as changing their dies, because their locks look like they haven't changed in years. I'm guessing this is dating from maybe the 60s. That's just my best guess, but I'm only guessing here. That's the Willie Bow, Wilson Bohannon. Their first patent was granted in, it was on April 17th, 1860. And like I say, they're still in business. That's pretty incredible. So, let's chuck this aside here. It's time for a quiz question. Let's get this out of the way. Hopefully pretty soon I'm going to be training at a local locksmith shop. Gentleman's name, the owner is Rafael Sierra. So let's just suppose that Mr. Sierra went to work, but he was unable to make keys for some reason. And the reason he gave was only in Spanish. The reason he couldn't make keys. If you know the answer as to why he couldn't make keys, the first person to email the answer to the lockpickinglebowski at gmail.com will win the Sparrow's sticker, 600 and 1,000 grit sandpaper, and the 10 key blanks, 5K1 quickset, 5SC1 schlag. So this is the reason he would give if he couldn't make keys. He'd say, la máquina está rota. We're going to be reviewing all of the quiz questions at the end of this webcast, just in case you missed them. But like I say, the very first person to email it to this address, it's very important, it has to go to this email address, will win this prize. All right, next up, as we go further down the rabbit hole, it's lock number 42. And that is, I'll say Gosner. I don't know if it's Gosner or Gosner, but this is the Gosner flexible adjustable cable lock. And this thing is so cool. Comes with two keys. And basically, you stick in your key and you unwind the cable. So you pull out the cable, and it unwinds and unwinds, and then when you're ready to lock something, you turn it to this one little divot, or any of six of the divots, and you pull out the cable from this spot here. I'm not going to do it now, but it'll detach, and then you lock up the item, and then you remove it as long as it's on one of these of six detents there. Gosner. What information do I have on Gosner or Gosner? I'm looking, and I don't think I have any info. This says San Francisco, but it's made in Japan, and this has San Francisco on it. I know they also, some of them have Sonoma, California on the back of them. Gosner. I'm guessing this is from the 1960s. And these are how the keys look. Those keys even look fairly 60s, I guess, if you could say that. Pretty cool. I'll say Gosner cable lock, number 42. Further down the rabbit hole, lock number 41, the Sergeant and Greenleaf 8088. Let's see. Sergeant and Greenleaf. I believe this was from out of the 1950s. And if you look very, very, very closely, down inside this hole, is a small ring. I believe it's a small split ring, and I think that's a shim guard. I'm not sure the other models came with a shim guard, but this is a four-digit combination lock, which is changeable. You basically can insert a key into the back, and you can see my video on that on how to change the combination. So again, I believe this is from the 1950s, Sergeant and Greenleaf 8088. That's lock number 41. Further down the rabbit hole we go. It's just going to get weird, man. I'll call this the Gougler or Gougler. This combination padlock has no numbers. It's got no letters. You basically go by clicks. And I think it turns about 17 clicks or so in either direction. I'm not going to give away the combination on this one, but you basically, some are four click combinations, some are five click combinations. In other words, you might turn this to the left 7 clicks, and then to the right 4 clicks, and then back to the left 8 clicks, and then back to the right 10 clicks, and then it will open. Pretty incredible. Gougler, it's the RD200. This is from the 1950s. They also make a bicycle version, the RD201 Deluxe. You can find new old stock on eBay right now for $45. They've got a really long shackle, and they're blue or red face instead of the chrome with the red dot. They were previously called Miller Keyless, but they sold out to Gougler in 1945. So that is from the 1950s. This is the Gougler, I'll just call it the Gougler Keyless Dial Click Combination Lock. That's out of Kent, Ohio. The RD200. Very cool. Very cool. It's one of my favorites. Definitely a shining star. It's time for another quiz question. And this time, it's Morse code, so I want you to get ready to do a screen capture. Like I say, we will revisit these at the very end. But this is crucial. This is for the Medico 51S 6-pin biaxial cylinder, the Huck 12-piece broken key extractor kit, and the 2-piece dimple pick set. But I want you to email the answer to a different email address this time. It must go to this email address, the first person to give the correct answer. And that isn't just figuring out what the question is, it's the answer to the question. The question is in Morse code. But you mustn't email the answer to the Morse code question to eclipsedave@gmail.com. Here is the question. So get ready to do a screen capture. And then we will revisit this at the toward the end of the broadcast so that you can get the information again if you missed it. So I'm going to leave this on the screen here just for a few seconds. And this is page 1 of 3. It's really about 2 1/3 pages of to make up the question. But this is the first portion. And the words might carry on from one page to the next. So there's page 1. Now we're going to go onward to page 2. And we're going to leave this on the screen again for a few seconds. Keep from screwing up here. If you want to do a screen capture for that, that would be just great. And again, the winner of this will get the Medico 51S 6-pin biaxial cylinder, the Huck 12-piece broken key extractor kit, and the 2-piece dimple pick set. Okay, that's page 2 of 3. Now for page 3 of 3, which really isn't much left. And it's just this portion right here, and this concludes the end of our second quiz question. That is the last portion of it right there. And the lucky winner, again, I want you to send your answer to this one to eclipsedave@gmail.com. Eclipsedave, all one word. First person to email the correct answer to the Morse code question will win those prizes. Right. Onward. Let's go down this rabbit hole. Drop the key. All right, we're gonna let that key stay on the floor. This is lock number 39. It's really kind of beautiful. It's brass and it's got a sort of a blue enamel sort of an inlay there. And the only other information on this lock, incredible enough, is I think the number 587 and made in occupied Japan. So that means it had to be made sometime during the military occupation, which was between 1945 and 1952. You can imagine what it takes to design something under a military occupation. That is it. And I just dropped the key. I think it's out of reach. Let me see here if I can grab it with my foot. Yeah, okay, success. Bear it with me here. Okay, and this is the key. The key says Uno or Uno. U-N-N-O. This is how the key appears. Works very smooth. So again, this is the pearl. That's lock number 39, made in occupied Japan. Very cool. Don't have anything else like it. Further down the rabbit hole we go. This is lock number 38. This is an Elgin. Elgin padlock. It's a circa 1941. That was a private label Ilco sold by Sears and Roebuck, as far as I know. This is either the 320B, black wrinkle finish, or the 320G, green wrinkle finish. I can't tell which. Whatever finish it is, I guess, is worn off, but it's definitely, it appears wrinkly. And doesn't say Ilco on the key, but it says Elgin, and this is the keyway. See if I can see that keyway there. I think this is a wafer lock, as far as I can tell. But works just like all these locks do. Elgin. Somewhere around 1941. Let's get down that rabbit hole. Again, as far as I know from the 1940s is this lock number 37, the Yale in Town. This is a dial combination lock with a key backup. And this one actually says, property of LA School District. Have no idea, man. But the key on it says Y11. That's the only information on the key. Yale in Town, it's the number 589, as far as I know, from the 1940s, made in the USA, and I can't figure out the combination to this. The combination that was provided didn't work, but the key does work. I believe this one is actually, I'm not sure if it's a right-left-right or a left-right-left, but I believe it's a three-digit combination lock. I think it's left-right. Let's see, I think it's right, left, and then right to open is how it goes, but I don't have the combo. Number 37, the Yale in Town, number 589. Dial combination lock with key backup. Rabbit hole. Down it we go. This is lock number 36. I think this is a hitch lock. But this is really big and beefy and rusty and weird. And it has a shutter on there to protect from gunk. My hands are getting dirty just holding it. I believe this is a General Motors hitch lock. The keys on it say Briggs & Stratton. It's General Motors Corp. It says Knockout on the key. Briggs & Stratton, made in USA. Briggs & Stratton Company. Basco, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Also on the key, it says Jet USA 80E. No idea what these cryptic things mean, but works fine. You put in the key, and it retracts this little bolt. And it's got a huge spring down inside there. I mean, the thing is ungodly. Can't really see down in there. Yeah, a little bit you can see a big spring in there. So that's the Briggs & Stratton. Since the key says knockout, I'm just going to call it the Briggs & Stratton knockout trailer hitch lock. The thing is you could use it as a paperweight or a weapon. That's lock number 36. I don't know what year. I can only guess by the patina on these things. But on down the rabbit hole we go. This is lock number 35. This is a Dynalock, and this looks like it was used for the military. It says U.S. set. Dynalock, it's a tubular 7-pin lock, but this one is key retaining. You turn the key, open the lock, you can't get the key out. I mean, it's key retaining. That's KR, buddy, key retaining. And until you close the shackle and turn the key back and pull it out, you're not getting your key back. Dynalock. U.S. set. The only thing it says on it, on the top, is lube here. It's the only clue you're going to get. Just cryptic information. Very strange. That's a fun tubular. Dynalock, number 35. Have no idea what year. I can only guess. On down the rabbit hole we go. This is lock number 34. And this is sort of like for cabinets, like glass doors. This is actually called the Yale Travel Lock. Yale Travel Lock. And of course, you insert your key here, and turn your key, and you can pull this off, and this little latch will hold your display case glass doors shut. I had very similar locks on my store when I had a retail clothing and accessory store for about 12 years. But this one looks like it's fairly recent. I'm not entirely sure. So I don't have a year on that for you. But pretty cool that Yale actually makes one. I'm sure the ones that I had were probably just cheap knockoffs of whatever, cheap no-names, I want to say. So, no idea what year. But it's definitely the Yale in Town Manufacturing Company. Made in the USA, lock number 34. Down the rabbit hole is lock number 33, and this is another cabinet lock. This is called Fort Lock, and this is double-sided, but it's directional. You can only fit your key in one way. It won't go in this way. It has to go in this way. And you turn your key, and then you can adjust your opening there for your cabinet doorway or display case or whatever. Fort Lock. Fort Lock, Chicago, Illinois. Came with two keys. Works just as smooth as ever. can't tell you what year. I just don't know. I don't have the information. And if you can fill in the blanks at any time, that's great. That's lock number 33, the Fort Lock display case door lock, if you want to call it that. This is lock number 32, the Eagle padlock, out of Terryville, Connecticut, made in the USA, buddy. Got the patent number on top, proudly. Works just as good as ever. But I think we're getting earlier and earlier. Needs that one. Again, Terryville, Connecticut, made in the USA. The key is Yale, though. And it even says Yale and Town Manufacturing. So you've got a Yale key for an Eagle lock. So I don't know if that was just retrofitted at a later time or what the relationship is there. With the key having LP3001 on it, but the lock has A36A and 87 on it, there's no relation in those numbers. So that makes me think maybe this key came at a later time. I'm just not sure. And I believe that is a wafer lock. The Eagle padlock, lock number 31. On we go. Lock number 30. This is a Yale padlock. Another wafer lock. This is the odd-shaped key. There's nothing on the key except P4539. Works just fine. No other information on this little guy here. Shackle looks pretty gnarly. Looks like it's been gnawed by a badger. Onward. It's lock number 29. Another Yale. Only thing you can see is on the back. Made in the USA. Rustless case. Very interesting keyway. And here's our key. Actually came with two keys. And it works just super. Very weird. But the keys say Yale and Town Manufacturing, made in USA, with the number 10 on it. That's lock number 29, a Yale padlock. No other information on it. Next up is another Yale. I think we're going further back in time. This is lock number 28. I think this is a pin tumbler lock, though. And that's our bidding. Actually works very smooth. It feels sort of mushy. The key says a national key, Cleveland, Ohio. But it is a Yale padlock. So, not really sure what the relationship is or if that came at a later time. They look pretty similar as far as the finish. Lock number 28, another Yale. But I believe that one is a pin tumbler, as far as I can see inside there. Next up is lock number 27. Oh, shit. I don't know what the... From blanks marked Yale. On the side here, it says Yale on the... Basically, it off like so. I guess that's for cabinets. And that's our keyway. Kind of a wicked little keyway. Not really sure what that would be on. My guess would be again, sliding glass doors or some sort of a sliding cabinet door. My best guess. The only thing on the lock is 32F46. The only information we've got, folks. That's not lock number 27. Now let's find out what hit the floor. This is lock number 26. Which is the herd out of Detroit. And this is looks like a pin tumbler lock. Mushy, but it works. Non-key retaining. Herd padlock out of Detroit. The key says Fair Oaks, California, USA, made by Neeson. I don't think I have any other information on that. I think I looked up Neeson and found a little bit on Neeson. But that's Herd padlock out of Detroit. And that was lock number 26 before I knocked something off the table here. So let me slide the rest of these locks over. Oh my God. All right. Further down the rabbit hole we go. This is lock number 25. This is another herd. It's really quite beautiful. Another little job out of Detroit. This is Herd model number 220, manufactured by E.P. Herd, Detroit. And this is the key. And it works just fine, if I can get it to. Thought it did. Got it in there right. Oh, turned it the wrong way. Okay. Odd. I actually turn the key. This one goes counterclockwise. And that is key retaining. Okay. You're not getting your key back until you close that shackle and pull your key out. You turn the key not clockwise, but you turn it counterclockwise. Key retaining herd lock. Beautiful little thing. Not really sure what year, but I know we're going back in time for sure. That's lock number 25, herd padlock. Lock number 24 is this Corbin, made in USA. Just says number 9970. Corbin Cabinet Lock Company, New Britain, Connecticut. That's what's on the key. Corbin. Obviously everyone has heard of Corbin. Alright, let's move right along to lock number 23. Lock number 23. It's another Corbin. Looks like it's earlier in time, as far as I can tell. Again, Cabinet Lock Company, New Britain, Connecticut. Beautiful lock, big shackle. And it says lubricate with graphite. Got the patent numbers and manufactured by Corbin Cabinet Lock Company. The shackle pops entirely out of this one. I'm not sure if that's the way it's supposed to be. This one could be damaged. I'm not really sure. So that's a Corbin padlock, padlock number 23. Moving right along. Number 22 is an even older Corbin, as far as I can tell. It just has the number 3832 on it. Really quite beautiful. Nice logo. New Britain, Connecticut, USA, proudly stamped on there. and this is an odd key, but here's how it goes. You push your key in, you actually have to push it that way, and the shackle comes up like so and then turns. And when you push it back, it snaps back into place, but you actually have to forcefully push your key in like so. No idea what year, but we're getting earlier and earlier. So let's try lock number 21. Lock number 21, Junk Junk Brothers combination padlock, Chicago. I'd guesstimate this would be in the 1920s. It's got the patent number of January 31st, 1922 on it. This is a right, left, right style combination. Right, left, right. With the numbers 0 to 29 on the dial face. That's lock number 21, Junk Junk Brothers. Mix up my combinations there. Next up is lock number 20, another Junk Junk Brothers. Very similar to the last one. Again, this is a right, left, right combination lock. Numbers 0 to 29. Probably not much different from the last one. That's lock number 20. Junk Junk Brothers dial combination padlock. Lock number 19. Another one from the 1920s. This is another Junk Junk Brothers. Numbers 0 through 14. And this is a right, left, right combination lock. And it works. And again, patented January 31st, 1922. So this is, I'm assuming, out of the 1920s. Very cool. That's lock number 19. Next up is lock number 18. Another Junk Junk Brothers, and this one's tiny. This is only a 2-digit combination lock. So I don't know how hard it would be to decipher that and just defeat this thing, but it's a right-left combination, and that's it. Right-left. And the way this one works is the numbers on the dial turn. You don't actually dial an arrow to numbers on the face of it. The numbers are actually on the dial itself. And these numbers go from 1, let's see, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, from 1 to 30. This is just a tiny little thing. The only information on it is D58487, which has nothing to do with anything, as far as nothing to do with the combination. But on the front there, it says it says Junk Junk Brothers Manufacturers, patented October 29th, 1912. So I believe this one is even earlier than the others. Chicago, Illinois. Very cool. That's lock number 18. Junk Junk Brothers Mini Dial Combination Padlock. Number 17 is a Dudley. These are pretty popular. They made a whole slew of these things, also out of Chicago, Illinois. Now the patent is September 7th, 1920. This goes from 0 to 39, and it is a right-left-right style combination. That's lock number 17. Dudley dial combination lock. On down the rabbit hole we go. It's lock number 16. It's another Dudley think the paint has worn off of this one. I think the paint is actually was actually black on that one, as far as I can tell around the edges. But you know, when you're dialing in the combination, your knuckles are just going to wear off that paint. Again, Dudley Lock Corporation out of Chicago, Illinois. My guess again is out of the 1920s. This is another right-left-right combination lock. The dial is very loose on this one and actually has some internal issues. A lot of patent numbers listed on the back of this one. Always beautiful inscriptions on these. That's lock number 16. The Dudley dial combination padlock. I think it's time for another quiz question. The winner of this quiz question will win all four challenge locks. You get Cheap Date, Schlage Silver Surfer, Precision Tuned, and Spring Fling. But I want you to email your answer to this question to the first email address we used, thelockpickinglebowski@gmail.com. But this will be in Braille, so you're going to have to decipher Braille, so get ready to do a screen capture. And again, we're going to review these at the end of the broadcast or webcast and make sure everybody got the questions. If I didn't screw up and lose them. Okay, so here comes the question. So if you want to do a screen capture of that, you'll need to decipher that. I've given you the answers in the webcast. So anytime we have a quiz question, we've already covered the answer. You just don't know when. But just research it. If you need to Google it, look it up. But the first person with the correct answer, it emails their answer to thelockpickinglebowski@gmail.com will win all four of those challenge locks. So hopefully you've had enough time to do your screen capture. Again, we'll revisit this at the end of the webcast in case you've missed this one. Alright, that is our third of a quiz question out of four. On down the rabbit hole we go. This is lock number 15. This is another Dudley. And again, I think the black has worn off of this one. Numbers go from 0 to 39. It's another right-left-right style combination. Patented September 7th, 1920. This is by Triple Metals Corporation out of Chicago, Illinois. Just beautiful. They took pride in stuff back then. Again, this is lock number 15, another Dudley dial combination padlock. Very cool. All right, on down the rabbit hole we go. This is lock number 14. This is Steen, S-T-E-E-N, combination lock out of Waukegan, Illinois. Dial combination padlock. This is another right-left-right style combination. Digits going from 0 to 39, and it does work. So maybe kids lock their bike up with this. I don't know. The dial looks very similar to Dudley. Junk Unk Brothers, it just looks similar to the ones of that time. So I'm going to guesstimate this to be around the 1920s again. Steen Combination Lock Company, Waukegan, Illinois. That's lock number 14. So we go down the rabbit hole. It's about to get weirder. This is a Sergeant Warded Padlock with a strange shaped shackle, which goes all the way down through these holes if you want to. This one actually has suffered some damage, where it looks like it's been dropped. So So I think I will end up bending that back out so that the shackle can go all the way through. I don't think it'll hurt it if I do that. Sergeant. Warded. And that's our key. Don't know what year. You know, I can only guess. My guess is the 1920s, but I really don't know. I just don't know. Maybe you can fill in the blanks on that. Next up is lock number 12. And that's another Yale with a massive warded key. Yale and Town Manufacturing Company. The lock has the number 3 on it. And so does the key. So I believe these are original. Works just fine. It's kind of strange when you press in on the shackle, the face plates actually move. So the innards are actually connected to these face plates. Very strange. But it's got Yale on the number 225 here. So I'm just going to call that a Yale padlock number 225 warded. No idea what year, but we'll definitely go earlier. Let's go back in time. Lock number 11. This one just says genuine brass. Another warded dealie. Rust proof. Made in USA. There's no other information on it. That's it. But works. Just fine. Got a chintzy, tinny kind of a click to it. No idea what year. But just judging from having warded keys, puts it a little bit earlier than others, I suppose. Next up, lock number 10. This is a Reese padlock. Warded key. This is out of Lancaster, Pennsylvania. Another one made in the USA. And it works just fine. Kind of a weird, small-looking shackle for the in relation to the body. But that's it. Reese padlock. Warded. Lancaster, PA. Made in the USA with pride. Number 10. Next up is one of my favorites. This is lock number 9. This is a Wise lock. I think they call it a barrel lock. You can find these all over eBay. I like everything about them. I like the shape. I really like the key. All the keys are just, they're different. Kind of reminds me of a pagoda lock, but it's non-key retaining. It just twists open like so. Really, really dig it, though. This one's in okay condition. You can find them in all sorts of conditions, really, from really ratted out, rusty, to almost brand new looking. And the key blanks are still available. Wise lock, concentric tube lock, the Faro Machine and Foundry Company, made in the USA. It's just got the number 60 on it. The key has a number 761 on it. Out of Cleveland, Ohio. This is our keyway. You can see these will depress down inside like so and open. That's lock number 9, the Wise lock. And now, reach this key. All right. Lock number 8. Adlake. I'm sure you're familiar with these. And this came with a key. I'm going to assume that it's original. But, actually works just fine. Springs right open. Have no idea what year. Patented March 20th, 1920 is what's on the lock. So again, I'm just going to put this in the 20s. This thing is huge. It's massive. It's heavy. Who knows what this thing guarded? You know, if locks could talk. That's lock number 8. Let's get further down that rabbit hole. We're on a roll here. Alright, lock number 7. My apologies on this one. I didn't have time really to research this one. I haven't even been able to open it. It just says L2242. I have no idea. It clicks when I turn it. It's very difficult to turn. Again, I have not opened it yet. It says JB MKL Company, Kent, Ohio. Patent applied for, made in USA is on the back, but I have no idea. I don't know if it's a click lock. There's no numbers, there's no letters. I can only assume it's by clicks, but I've tried the clicks, 2242, left and right, and whatever. Haven't been able to open it. If you know anything about it, hit me. That's lock number 7, mystery. All right, lock number 6. Let me go further down this rabbit hole. MW Company out of New Haven, Connecticut. And this is our key. Very strange. You just insert the key the entire way, and it springs right open. But it's got this strange guard, this sort of warding on the front. That's number 6. MW Company. Padlock out of New Haven, Connecticut. I have no idea what year, but it's pretty early. I don't know if the key is original or not. This could have just been stamped out of any type of metal, but it does work. So I'll take it. That's lock number 6, MW Company Padlock. Lock number 5 is another weirdie. The logo on the front is just gorgeous. It's S and C. That is Sargent and Company, I believe, before they got together with Greenleaf. This is our key. It's actually got a strange twist in it, just like the weird warding on the front. So this is how it opens. You push in, and then you turn 90 degrees, and it pushes in further, and then you turn to the right, and it moves the locking paw on the inside. Close it, turn it back to the left, pull out, rotate 90 degrees, and back out again. Works just fine. Really rusty on the inside, but I believe that's pretty early. I have no idea what year. Sargent and Company. Very beautiful. Very interesting. Weird. Just weird. It's about to get weirder. Trust me. Stick with me here. That's lock number 5. Sargent and Company. This is lock, or I don't know if you want to call it a lock. I just call it a metal bar lock. It's got a specialty screw head. So, I don't know, man. This is just weird. You insert the key. That's how the end of the key looks. You insert the key, and you go counterclockwise. I've counted. It takes 4.5 turns. Once you turn this 4.5 turns counterclockwise, then this swings open. You turn it again clockwise, another 4.5 turns, screws that back down inside there. Damn, I have no idea what year. I have no idea what it's called. There's no markings on it. If you have any information, let me know. That's number 4. Okay, weirder yet. This is lock number 3. Massive. GB Massive. It just says BTE SGDG. Have no idea. But this is the key. And that's our keyhole. You basically insert this on the side, but it'll only go in one direction. It won't go this way. You have to turn it, and it goes in further. What you do is you press in, and it actually launches the shackle out. It's got pretty heavy spring tension. Of course, non-key retaining, and then just replace it like so. It just hooks into place. I've found nothing online about this. It's who knows what year. Massive. The GB Massive with the strange tubular key with four prongs. That's lock number 3, Massive padlock. Let's get weird. This is lock number 2. I just call it the China chain lock. This is it here. Only one side comes out. This is our key. On the key, it's actually a Corbin cabinet lock division key, New Britain, Connecticut. But I would assume that's not original. I just, who knows? But you turn the key and it pops open this side here, the left side. Non-key retaining. And then you just enter this back in here and snap it shut. Strange as can be, man. The China chain lock with Corbin key. Who knows what year? Who knows who or what this was shackled to? Very early. Have no idea what year. We know where it came from. It came from China, but there's no other information on it, as far as I can tell. That's lock number 2, the China chain lock with Corbin key. All right, last one on our list. So lock number 1, the weirdest one yet. The Thura Universal 4-letter combination lock. Okay, as far as this lock goes, I have studied and tried to find information on this. The only information I found on this was a previous eBay auction. And the guy, his information, he says, you are bidding on a combination lock that I got from my uncle when I was 10 in 1970. He had a wooden box full of old locks and told me that if I could guess the combination, I could keep it. My two brothers and sisters and I played with the lock for weeks, and one day someone got the code. When I asked my uncle if we had it right, he laughed and told me he never knew what it was. I think this lock is very unusual, as I have only seen one here on eBay, and it was made in Germany, and this one seems very domestic. The lock works as it should. I could find nothing about Thura online, and now you have a chance to figure it out for yourself. I'd be happy to send other pictures or answer any questions you may have. And that's on his eBay ad. So when I looked at the pictures of the eBay ad, I noticed how it was stamped. Thura Universal. And the letters that were used. And this one is also misstamped, where Thura is heavier than Universal. And actually, it's actually DRP on the right-hand side of that, and you can't see the DRP that well. And when I got to looking at it closer, I noticed that there were three notches where somebody tried to cut the shackle at the top. And as I looked closer, I had the same lock. The only other thing that I've found on this was something similar with a chain. Now, I know what you might be thinking, the China chain lock. I tried it. It's actually too long. This is a lot shorter, so they are not related. And I see the letters here are different. The letter R. I'm not sure there's even an R listed. That's the information that I found on this. So very strange. And when I took a close look at the letters offered on this lock, this is the pattern that I found. Dial number one, if you put them in where the alphabet is earliest on the left, C is the earliest letter, A on dial two, and F, and then again, A on dial number four. That's the order they go in. Here's another way to look at this chart. Dial number one, two, three, and four. If you put them in order with the earliest letter of the alphabet at the very top, C-A-F-A. This is what I've found. You've got two A's, two Y's, two U's, two O's, two I's, and two E's. Now, I don't know how many, I would never make the combination to be in a word. That'd be too obvious. But let's say you did. How many words do you know where the third letter is Q in a four-letter word? How many words do you know of where the first letter is X in a four-letter word, but there's no R for like X-ray? How many words do you know that end in certain vowels that are four letters long? It really makes you wonder. The only other information that I found on this lock was something written in German. One of the words that I found was Schloss. Schloss means castle. So it really makes me wonder, was this lock possibly made by someone? Were they in a castle? Were they sane? Why did they choose these letters? Were they filled with hate? Were they trying to get a cryptic message out? Were they trapped in a cage? Did they feel safe? Or had they given up all hope? Were they just trying to cope? With being alone? Or were they just done? With life. We may never know. Lock number one, the third universal four-letter combination lock. That's all the way further we're going to go down this rabbit hole, folks. It's time to revisit our quiz questions. For the Morse code, if you missed it, here's your chance to do another screen capture. This is page one. I'm going to leave this up for a few seconds. I hope you've really dug this, man. I've spent hours and hours and hours trying to put this together and tried to put something together that was cool, and I hope you dug it. I hope it was informative, and I hope you can fill in the blanks, and I hope you answer the quiz questions, and I hope you win. If you stuck with me through this, I really appreciate it. Here's page two. If you want to get a screen capture of that. Like I say, folks, the answers are there. You've been given the answers. All through the webcast, it's been information that's been given, historical information. So there's page 2. Now let's do page 3 of the Morse code question. I'm sorry, the Braille, what was I saying? Braille question. And then after this, we'll do the Morse code. Alright, there's page 3 of the Braille. Now for the Morse code. If you want to do a screen capture of that, if you can decipher that. Okay, I think that should suffice. All right, we're ready for our final question. Final question. And their winner will win the Guardian's card key cable lock. Date was Wilson Bohannon granted their first patent? I'm looking for the month, day, and year. First person to email the correct answer to eclipsedave@gmail.com wins the Guardian's card key cable lock. Let's see. I can't find the envelope. I think the envelope to our first quiz question is buried. So that's that. That concludes our broadcast of The Lockpicking Lebowski Presents Down the Rabbit Hole, A Padlock Journey. And the Big Lebowski is paging me, so I gotta go. And I will see you all next time.